So I think investors should care, but not get overly worried at this point in time. When we do the calculations, you basically find out that the amount of tariffs that have been announced so far and been put into place amount to about 0.1% of GDP. That ultimate effect is not something that is overly alarming and is, in fact, materially dwarfed by the amount of stimulus coming through in the form of tax cuts and tax reform, which is about 0.5% of GDP. So at this point in time, it's something to keep an eye on, but the magnitude is not big enough to actually change the directional kind of thought process on where the economy and profits are going.
So
Having
where
said that, if it escalates further, escalating further, like if you got to the point of, the U.S. putting tariffs on all, 25% tariff on all Chinese goods and multiple other nations at the same time, then you could actually see something that's closer to a 1% effect on GDP and something that I think would actually be more alarming and have a bigger impact on the economy and financial profits.
Jay, so let me push you on this, though. We are
Sure.
now at the point where the Dow has lost its gains for the year. I mean, you're talking about a year where tax reform was passed, where the economy is hitting levels we haven't seen in Lord knows how long, and where the unemployment rate is at these historic lows too. Would you imagine that we would be talking about the Dow making absolutely no progress in a year like that? What do you think happens by the end of the year? What will we look back and say that this year was all about in the markets?
So I think we have to do, we also have to look back at 2017 and recognize that we had
The
a
huge
really
build,
strong
right?
gains that year, that we got to basically relatively high valuations on prognosis or prognostications that we were going to have really strong gains again in 2018. So to see kind of some meager progress in 2018 on the back of really strong returns in 2017 probably shouldn't be all that surprising to investors. From our perspective, this is a fairly healthy kind of moderation in valuations in an otherwise long-term economic expansion that really doesn't seem to have any good signs of ending at this point in time. We're kind of cognizant of how long this expansion has run. We think investors need to be doing their homework and trying to assess what could bring about the end of the expansion. But so long as that expansion continues, it's more likely than not that equities will continue to notch in some gains longer term.
RJ, let's talk about the bond market. Treasuries, every time we turn around, we think we're headed for the 10-year to be hitting a yield of 3%. Every time we think that's going to happen, something else comes and weighs down those yields once again. It's a hard place if you're looking to actually make any money. Is it different in the municipal bond market?
No. Muni bonds and treasuries have pretty strong correlations in terms of overall rates direction. Your point about you hit 3%, you get above it for a short period of time, and then something happens, whether it's Italy or whether it's the next tweet regarding trade conflict. There clearly has been some resistance to U.S. rates remaining above 3% on the 10-year as an indication. The muni side's done a little bit better this year. Issuance in munis is down about 25% compared to where we were over the past couple of years at this point. That's the tailwind to the tax bill. Issuance surged before the tax bill. So munis are almost flat on the year, just a little bit to the negative. Generally, all fixed income, outside of high-yield corporates to some degree, are posting mildly negative returns because we've been in a bond bear market for this year and really since Brexit occurred. It's
And you
been
don't see any
choppy,
end?
but generally, returns are tough.
You don't see any
No,
end
I
in
think
sight?
we've a lot of the worst is behind us. Think of it this way. The Fed is normalizing monetary policy, raising rates, raising dots, which tells you where they expect rates to go. And they're also shrinking their balance sheet. That's a challenge to financial assets, obviously a challenge to bond returns. If the 10-year can get above three, I think the next discussion will be how much further does it go? Our view by the end of the year is the 10-year should be somewhere around 3.25. And long term, we have a lot of headwinds to global growth. The trade conflicts are a challenge. Eurozone cohesion is a challenge to U.S. rates. I doubt that we'll see 4% in years to come. So that means that rates have backed up quite a bit, and we might be in the seventh inning of what has been a reset higher in a normalization of monetary policy. Bonds might not be so bad.
Okay. RJ, Jason, thank you both for your time today.
Hey there. Thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.